won't be here long, praise God. We just want to share some scriptures and look into the reality of God's word. Somewhere in Psalms 119 it says, what would can a young man cleanse his way, change his way? His answer was, take heed according to the word of God. So live it according to the word of God. Amen. And it's probably from Psalms 34 and 11. David declared, come ye children, listen to me. I will show you how to be successful with God. How many want to be successful with God?
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. I can remember as a young Christian overseas, we had so much activity going and it was rounded up folks. Because we didn't really have anything else to do, so we just shared the gospel and went from place to place, and it was a member of our team who got sick, and I was just very young and all right. She got sick and went into the hospital, and so they came and got a couple of brothers, and I was just young in the Lord, I'm tagging along, and said, come on, man, we've got to go pray for Sister So-and-so. I said, all right, and we got there, and she had all of the tubes and veins that they have on here in the hospital, all of the things going all over the place. And we prayed in the name of Jesus that she would get well. Let's pray. And I had never seen anything outstanding from praying before, but right then you could tell that she received healing. And it was at nighttime, and she, as we was getting ready to go, she was taking away some of the things they had attached to her. And she was sitting up and ready to leave, get out of the bed. And I'm going, wow. And one of the guys says, just have faith in the name of Jesus. And the next morning she was out of the hospital, and she never had any kind of sickness again. So what I'm trying to share with you is that nothing's too hard for God. In the name of Jesus, faith in that name, if you take ownership of that name, nothing's too hard, nothing's difficult at all. And so, the Lord works in ways that we don't think about. We just don't know how he's going to come through. We just know that he comes through. And I remember how I got more knowledge of the Holy Ghost riding a bus, South Korea. And everybody looks the same in a nation like that. It's called nationalists. They all look alike. And I got on the bus, and as I was standing out, the bus was rocking and going on. I saw someone holding a book in the hand, kind of like this. And it said on that book says, the Holy Ghost in you, the Holy Spirit in you. And I said to the person holding that book, I said, I need a book like that. And she said, oh, really? I said, yes, here, you can have it. There's a crowded bus full of Koreans, me, a black guy, and a white woman that I was talking to. So she gave me the book, and I went back to my place to hold on to keep them. And as the bus came to the next stop, I wanted to turn around and thank her for the book. She wasn't there. I'm looking all around. Well, then I can say, Sister Denise, that might have been a plan of an angel right there, delivering to me what I needed at that hour, at that time. Information on the power of the Holy Ghost in your life. And how many ever went to a rummage sale or a garage sale and found something of value? Or walking down the street, you put trash out on the curb and you find something in there that's valuable to you, but somebody has discarded and rejected. Yeah. I go to the thrift store, what have you. Remember one time I went to a thrift store, it was called Fire Sale or something like that. The department store had a fire. I was finding knit shirts amongst all that stuff in there. I said, wow, that's a nice looking knit. Well, you know, I bought that knit shirt and I wore it back when I was young and treatment for real good and everything. And I kept it for years and years until my elbows were worn out. And I said, boy, and I finally threw it away. I said, that this shirt was of great value to me, and I bought it from a fire sale somewhere. I said, but something that someone discarded. And this is what is going on in a lot of Christian lives today, is that we have discarded, thrown away the precious stuff. So we have to keep an eye on the precious stuff. Tell your neighbor, watch out for the precious stuff. There could be some great value there. Hallelujah. So and I'm going to, let's look into, if I had anything to put on what I'm going to say today, I want to say grace and truth. Grace and truth operating in your life. And you can't really time grace. Grace just happens. Favoritism. Whatever you may be doing, you go through your course of life, then you recognize that's the God's grace. Had nothing to do with it, but it's just God's grace giving me favor. And then you recognize that before long, and I think it's over here and going to be in the book of Acts. Let me see if I can get to the book of Acts. Probably somewhere around the fourth chapter, I do believe. Four and 12. And this is what it's going to say. Neither is there salvation in any other. For there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby they must be saved. There is none other. And then just before that you read verse 11. This is the stone which was set at naught of the builders, which has become the head of the corner. That's Acts 4:11, verse 12. We'll just read it. And this is the stone which the master builders rejected. This is not good enough. This won't fit. This won't work with our architect or structure or piece, what have you. So the builders, the master builders, rejected it. And that stone, spiritually speaking, is the name of Jesus. It was rejected. Now, if you go into, I spent a little time in the book of St. John, the first chapter. Let's just do a subtitle. How can a young man make it on the earth? How can a young man be successful with God? How can anybody find success with God? Some basic truths that we must know and have revelation of. I remember as a kid going to my grandmother's house. I remember the little green Bibles you could put in your pocket. The little green New Testaments. Of course, it was always the first thing in there was the four Gospels, and I would flip through, and I would come to the book of John, and I would say, in the beginning. That's curious. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. So my curiosity, how did all of this begin? Where did it come from? Where did I come from? In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. Verse 3, all things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. Alright, I'm going to read that again. All things were by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. Oh, hallelujah. I'm going to go down to verse 9. That was the true light which lighteth every man that come into the world, gives wisdom, gives understanding, gives direction. That's what light. He was that true light. He was in the world, and the world was made by Him, and the world did not recognize Him. He came into His very own creation that He had made. Everything, all the splendor, even the wonderful human race that He had made, and the Bible says He dwelt among them, and they did not even recognize their Creator. So, what did they do? We're going down to chapter 12. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. The word was made flesh, dwelt among us. And you can go on in verse 16. Of his fullness that we all receive grace for grace. But the key here, if you learn any scripture in the Bible, would be St. John, the first chapter, verse 12. But as many as receive him, the one that was rejected, and he's still rejected today in many circles and wherever you might go, the name of Jesus is still rejected, but as many as receive him, to them God gives the right to be called his child. We went over that in Sunday school this morning. You can mess with the law or you can mess with grace. One of the two you don't have to find yourself under. And here he says, as many as received him, he gave them the right to be called a child of God. Now, receiving that right and knowing that you have that right gives you some tremendous power on this earth that he created. Glory to God. But if you put it to the curb, reject it, put it in the trash bin or whatever, and just lay it to the side, and how do we do that? Don't come to Bible study, don't come to prayer, don't come to church service halfway in, halfway out. Don't pray. Don't really give it a whole lot of time, put a lot of value into that name of Jesus, the study of Jesus as his life. Then you are rejecting what has given you power to make it on this earth. Power over sin, sickness, and disease. Woo!
Amen.
Thought I might get, have to settle y'all down after that. But power over sin, power over sickness, and power over disease. God in heaven has none of it. Glory to God. No sickness, no sin, no disease. So he's giving you as his kinfolks the same stuff that he has. Given us. In the beginning was the word. Well, how can a young man know about this? He has to clean up his way. Glory to God. Verse 15 of the St. John, the first chapter, says, John bore witness of him and cried, saying, this was he of whom I speak. He cometh after me, is preferred before me, he was before me. See, John says, you see me, you see my ministry, but I'm telling you, he had a ministry before me. It's John says, I'm preaching and preparing the way, trying to get you to repent and so forth, but the one that I'm really preaching about, trying to tell you about, he existed before I did. And his existence was to prepare a way for you. Let me just get this square away here. So, verse 30 of St. John, the first chapter. This is he whom I said, after me cometh a man which is preferred before me. He was before me. I knew him not, but he should be manifested to Israel. Therefore, am I come baptizing in water. Now, we're going to jump back to the Old Testament just a little bit, if you would, with me to Proverbs 3:19. It declares, the Lord, by his wisdom, made the earth. The Lord, by his wisdom, made the earth. Glory to God. By understanding, he established the heavens. By his knowledge, the depths are broken up, the clouds drop down the dew. My son, let not them depart from thine eyes. Keep sound wisdom. Verse 25, be not afraid of sudden fear. Verse 26, for the Lord should be thy confidence. and shall keep thy foot from being taken. Then no surprises, no negative surprises in life. No things that's going to get you down, that's going to do you in, that's going to take you by surprise if you're walking in the wisdom and the revelation of Jesus Christ and his name on the earth. There is no deliverance nowhere else on the earth. There's only one name given on the earth whereby man can be successful. That is the name of Jesus. And the apostles saw that when they saw this sick man, and they said to him, just spoke to him words, rise up and walk. Rise up and walk. And they were so astonished at the results. Peter would say, why are you looking at us like we did some great thing? This is because there's faith in that name. Faith in that name made this man get up and walk. So what I'm going to have to submit to us today is that, do we really have faith in that name as we walk the earth? I'm going to tell you, it's very important. Because of all of God's creation, there's only one part that he has given over to the dominion of man, and that is the earth that you and I walk on, breathe on. Now, the earth is either going to allow you to dictate to it, or it's going to dictate to you what you get out of it. Oh, it's kind of quiet. But that is the reality. Some people call it life. It's going to direct you, or you're going to direct what you want out of here while you're here. And you don't have to settle for anything if you know about that I have been given the right to be the child of God. So I have the right to walk around with dominion. I have the right to walk around with authority. That is my right, and I'm going to exercise it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Psalms 33:69. I'm going to say a little bit more about what we already have went through. But it says there in Psalms 33:69 that by the word of the Lord were the heavens made. Psalms 33:6-9. By the word of the Lord were the heavens made, and all the hosts of them by the breath of his mouth. He gathered the waters of the sea together as a heap. He laid up the depth in storehouses. Let all the earth fill the Lord, and let all the inhabitants of the world stand in awe of him. For he spake, it was done. He commanded, and it stood fast. See, that's not a whole lot of difficulty, sweat equity in that. It's just that he says, he spake. And that's what you and I are going to have to get used to doing, is speaking. He spake, and it was done. He made a command, and it stood fast. I want to tell you today, start talking. I'm going to tell you today, start throwing around some authority. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I went to get my yearly physical just this week, and the doctor checked me out. Blood pressure 127, I don't know, 75, something like that. And then he's feeling around, EKG and all that. Oh, yeah, you're good, man. Feeling on my feet. Oh, yeah, good blood pressure. Wow, what a pulse. Man, you're okay. I said, I take these things every year, but you guys just get paid for nothing. I come in here with authority.
Amen. Hallelujah.
So, what I'm trying to say is that the way you believe, you got to keep talking. You got to keep throwing around some authority. Now, the devil wants to throw some poverty your way. That's why it says in St. John 10:10, I come that you might have life and that you might have it abundantly.
Amen.
Not just barely get by, not just paycheck to paycheck as we all what have you, but abundance. more than you need.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's the word of the Lord. And as 80% of this room has not bought into that yet. We hear it, but we have not bought into it. He came that I might have life, and I came, but life in abundance. Glory to God. And you got all kind of oppositions that wants to push you off of that reality. The sounds going out throughout all of the world every day trying to push you off that cliff. You wind up into some situation that you don't want to be in. Well, I hope the church is hearing me today. Glory by the word of the Lord with the heavens made. Look at Psalms 116 and 6. This is a Psalm of David. This is what he said in his revelation understanding as he's getting an understanding of the Lord. Verse 5, he says, gracious is the Lord and righteous, yea, our God is merciful. The Lord preserve the simple. He says, I was brought low. That translated, I was brought low, is that life tried to push me. Life tried to push me into despair. And it wasn't just a gentle push, but it was a heavy nudge. Before I could catch my steps, I was falling. That's what life did. Boom. I was brought low. The devil took his shot. Life came after me. But then he says, what did he say after that?
Did he help me?
But he helped me.
Amen.
Glory. See, life, the devil, the little G.O.D. in this world is going to come after you with not a gentle push, but a big force. Ooh, push you off the cliff, off track, off reality. But the fool has said in his heart, as I said a week or so ago, there is no God. That's the fool. The wise man, it says, in the beginning was the Word. And the Word was God, and the Word was with God. And everything that was made by Him. And He upholds all things by the Word of His power. And without Him, nothing consists.
Amen.
And that is whose help I get.
Amen.
By my faith and reality in what He has done for me, when life push, I'm helped.
Yes.
See, I wish I could sit up here and tell you that poverty doesn't knock at the door. Sickness doesn't knock at the door. I wish I could tell you despair and angry and worry and all this doesn't knock at your door. I wish I could tell you that. But the little G-O-D of this world is going around like a roaring lion trying to push what he can. And we learned a few weeks ago that the bold, the righteous, as bold as a what? A lion. They roar back.
Get on.
Amen. Alright. Here's what he said in verse 7 when life pushed him. Return unto thy rest, O my soul. Glory. Don't hit him with a blow, but he says, my mind, your soul is your mind. Don't y'all disturb your word. He says, return unto your rest, O my soul. God help me. God is helping me. Devil comes, shows up, he push, but God is my help, so I'm not going to be worried. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Cast all your cares upon Him, for He does what? Don't be so anxious. Don't be so out of sorts. That's what most folks are. They're just anxious, out of sorts. Can't see their way. But He says, return to your rest, O my soul. For the Lord hath dealt how? Big with me.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Ooh, hallelujah. One author says, makes my feet like hinds' feet. Set me up on the high places of the earth. Hallelujah. I can walk to the edge of the cliff and look over and observe. Got good foot. I'm not going to slip. Hallelujah. Go to the high places of the earth. For thou hast delivered my soul from death, mine eyes from tears, and my feet from falling. I will walk before the Lord, where? in the land of the living. That's what the devil really wants you.
Hallelujah.
He wants you walking up there in heaven. He don't want you down here controlling, manipulating, dominating, calling the shots.
That's right.
He don't want you down here. Get out of here. The Bible says, on the earth, the Lord has created great things, but the earth he gave to the children of men. It's your right to walk around here with authority and dominion and power. Hallelujah. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. This is William's favorite verse. Verse 10. I believe.
Yes, Lord.
Therefore have I spoken. I was in the dumps. I was a loser. I was greatly afflicted with all of the stuff of the devil, but the Lord did what brought me up into a large place. Bountiful place. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So I want to tell you today that for as many as received him, to them gave he power to become children of God. But some that reject. Some that reject. You just can't say in the name of Jesus and believe in that name and that everything's going to be okay for you. I'm telling you today that the name of Jesus is the best power on the face of the earth today. It destroys anything and everything has to bow to someone using that name in faith. There's nothing on earth that's powerful or can overrule that name.
Amen.
A believer utilizing that name and whatever he wants on earth is going to come out good. Amen. Once over, say praise the Lord. And all that praise God. Ooh, hallelujah. Glory to God. It says in Psalms 118, all of these psalms are pretty much running together. Psalms 118, 14, and 15 is that the voice of the righteous. I'm going to look at verse 13 of Psalms 118. Thou hast thrust sore at me that I might fall. That's what the devil did.
Yes.
He pushed me so hard that I might fall over. But the Lord helped me.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because I'm his child, I'm his kinfolk, yes, he's going to help me out. The Lord helped me. Praise God. The Lord is my strength and song, and has become my salvation.
Hallelujah.
The voice of rejoicing and salvation is in the tabernacles of the righteous.
Yes.
The right hand of the Lord do great stuff.
Yes.
See, the righteous in this tabernacle, everywhere he goes, is thankful. Hallelujah. Glory. Look what God is doing. Recession. Lay off. You name it, sickness, disease, flu season, Tylenol season, night cruel season. Everybody, hurry up, run to the drugstore, get you something to fight off. Everybody's running to the store. In the name of Jesus, I'm healed by his stripes. Go on about your business. Oh, hallelujah. I hope y'all with me today, church. I'm trying to tell you that the name of Jesus is the best thing you got. And for a young man, the sooner you learn that, so much better for you.
Amen.
I learned that as a young man.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. And I'm telling you, standing here before God, it would take something for me to get a headache. I can't. What is that? A cold, a flu. Every once in a while, I might tear up something, twist the ankle, pull the leg, something. Because they call me a weekend warrior, it's an old fool, I don't know what he's still having. But his forehead has no heart, bad heartbeat, no blood, no pressure, what? Words from weapons? No, they say, you are good. I say, the only thing different from me and anybody else I believe is that I speak what I believe.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. You can ask my kids, they'll tell you. He's just an old fool when it comes to the word. Glory to God. Well, here it is right here, Psalms 118, verse 22. Listen, verse 21. Verse 20. This day of the Lord into which the righteous shall enter, I will praise thee, for thou hast heard me and hast become my salvation, my deliverance. The stone which the builders refused has become the headstone of the corner. This is the Lord's doing. It's marvelous in our eyes. This is the day which the Lord has made. We will rejoice and we'll be what? Glad. Save now, I beseech thee, O Lord, O Lord. I ask thee, send what? Oh, man. I'm telling you. Hallelujah. Send some prosperity. Send some good stuff. Send more than abundance. Hallelujah. Make my life full. Send it now. Send it, send it, send it. Why? Because I have walked into the door that the Lord has opened for me. The door that not just anybody can walk in, it's the door called that the righteous can enter into. Yeah. How do I enter into his grace, his throne room, and get all the help I want? The devil push, but God helps. The devil strikes me hard, knock me off, try to knock me off the cliff, but the Lord helped me. The Bible says the throne of grace. Come find some help. If you learn as a young person, an old person as well, how to get into the presence of God and stay in the presence of God. His word is what his presence
Hallelujah.
Is.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I used to take those little New Testament Bibles and throw them to the side when it came party time. Weekend. Glory to God. I'm the only one who used to do that. Put them in the drawer. Don't have time for that word. I got other things to do. Life was so hard then. But all of a sudden, sick all the time back then, but all of a sudden, when I take the word, the Bible says the word is a light unto my feet, a light unto my pathway. Man, then I can see where I'm going. That's how you stay in the presence of God, is that you absorb, you just allow yourself to be just so quenched with his word. And the contrary stuff is, well, the things that's on TV, I don't know, some of these shows, what they call reality shows. Oh, man, it's so crazy stuff on TV. Spend hours in front of it when you could be observing the word of God. You can be setting your path straight. Ooh, the devil's coming after you, trying to give you poverty. You trying to make it in the world economically. Here's the word right here. Encouraging you. You can do it. Put a dream in your head. The Bible says young man will speak visions, and old man will dream dreams. Because of the revelation of the Lord. But if you take it and discard it, the stone that the builders rejected, throw it away, push it to the side. It's not that important. It's not that tough, top priority in life. That's the stone that the builders rejected. The Bible says it's become the chief cornerstone of all stones. That's the main stone. That's the main way to make it. Hold on to that stone. Some folks are just discarded. Well, how do you know things are discarded? Wednesday night, five people in Bible study. I'm bothering folks a little bit here. It's just too hot. It's 100 degrees.
Amen.
Oh, man, who want to go in that fellowship hall? It's not 100 degrees there. That's 100 degrees outside. It's all kind of reasons and excuses not to be what? In front of the word of God.
Amen.
Oh, yeah. The reality show is coming on at 8 o'clock. I was spending an hour in front of that instead of an hour in the Bible. That's the stone that the builders rejected. You rejected the chief stone. Opportune time to absorb the word. Opportune time to say the word. Opportune time to fellowship. Opportune time to express When you're in the congregation of the righteous, and it's, let's praise the Lord, and he just clamp up. Stone that the builders rejected. You put that word in your mouth, it can become life to them that find it, and healing to all of their flesh. Oh, I wish I could get you to buy that. I guarantee you, you go back to the doctor and say, "Doc, this prescription, don't need it. Doc, this regimen, that's not what you need it for me." But it's the word. But you got to buy into the word. You got to sell it. Hallelujah. Here's the deal. Well, you know when they say, burn your bridges? There's some bridges you got to burn. Oh. Some bridges you got to burn as a young man. Friendship with the world, the wrong kind of friends, you got to burn those bridges. Which means I don't come back. Not coming back this way again. When I was a young man, I just named the day and the time, and I could make one phone call and have everybody in the party. It would be on. Weekday, 5 o'clock, 5:30 at my place, bring your ashtrays. Some of y'all went over your head. That's good. Glass house. I know how I got that name. Some of you guys don't know where it's located. That's good. Glory to God. But once I got saved as a young man, 23, I do believe, it wasn't more than just a week. Everybody was calling, trying to get us to go. I changed my ways. As many as received him, I recognized my power right away. I recognized who I was in Christ. I didn't know much about nothing else. But once that burden of sin was off, I knew that if I'm a child of God, it's got to be things that are going to get a whole lot better. There ain't nothing they can do to invite me back to where I was. And let me tell you, they tried. Every day. Until they finally said, "Hey, say, you'll come back. You'll be back. Whatever that stuff that you took, walk." That's exactly what they said to me. That was the last time I lit anything, the last time I drank anything, and the last time I did anything. It's a whole bunch of stuff. I'm trying to tell you. Glory to God. And if I find, I don't want to brag myself, but I just want to tell you this. Listen, come learn, and you can learn how to be successful with God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I can get up any morning and day and call my own shots. What I'm born, what I'm going to do, I have no loss. But me. I sleep. I could until I get tired of sleeping. This is not bragging. I'm just telling you. This is what I found marching with God. Yeah. If I satisfy my wife, she told me that if you bring 3 months of a certain income, you can get that car you've been on. Guess what? Look out. Because I'm talking what I believe.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Now, people say, man, what does the Bible say? Sin now, prosperity.
Right.
Have life now. When? In abundance. Now.
Now.
Live free, worry free. When? Now.
Amen.
But the little G-O-D of this world says, now I'm going to push you to the edge of this cliff, and your mind is going to be so disturbed. I said this, when the devil show up, so go back to your rest. Rest. Go back to that peace you had before this mess popped up. Glory. He's just like a lion. So the devil say to us, you can't be in a position to give. You can't live. You say, settle down, mind. Settle down. What does the word say? and you go by that. Oh boy, I know it's so hot in here, I'm kind of worried about y'all. But verse 118 and 22, the stone which the builders refused has become the headstone of the corner. This is the Lord's doing. It's marvelous in our eyes. I beseech thee, Lord, send prosperity. So what? All I want to tell you to us today is that start getting closer to God. Start as a young person saying that I want to know how God can give me light on life. I want to know how I can say a thing and believe it. I want to know how that if my child gets sick, that my first call is not to 911. Ooh, I know that's hard. Because you love your babies. But that first action, in the name of Jesus. Absolutely. Come what may, in the name of Jesus. Get out of here, Satan. Because he's real. He'll knock on your door, he'll knock on your heart, he'll knock on your head, and you got to know that by his stripes, I'm healed. In the name of Jesus. Glory. That's the only name given among men on earth, under heaven, whereby they can be delivered. Only that name. You got to buy into it. You got to buy into it. Let's stand if we will, please, God. We're going to need some prayer. I'm going to ask Brother Curtis, come on. We're going to pray. If you want me to touch and agree with you.